homies. It's your boy Dave, and I'm back today. We about to take a look at Rainbow Stargazer, okay? And with that type of name, with that type of intro, Stargazer, I mean, come on. This almost sounds really sci-fi. I saw a look at the cover art. Let's see, I'm not going to play just yet, but it's really, really interesting, that cover art. Gripping a rainbow. Rainbow, you know, usually when we see rainbows, we think happiness. But then it's surrounded by, like most of the artwork looks more like dread, like stuff you'll see in like a graveyard or something like that. So it's kind of like a duality of good and evil right here. It was very interesting. It's like the hand from the grave is ripping out any joy or any happiness that you may have. That's very interesting. Just off the album art alone. And usually if the album art is good, then you know the music's about to be good. Now, I don't know anything about this band. It's my first time hearing music by them, so let's go ahead and shut up and turn up. Ooh, 1976. Very interesting, that guitar effect right there. Vocals are, wow. Okay, hold on, before we move on. What's interesting, and I don't know if this is because of an audio, audio quality or anything, but it almost sounds, what's that word I'm looking for? Or kind of sounds like pushed. The vocals kind of sound like pushed back. It's definitely giving like a far out kind of vibe from it. And it might be because it was made in the 70s. But with the song name Stargazer, that's very interesting that I'm starting to hear, or at least what I think I hear, some type of space elements. Talk about this guy's voice. That is amazing, especially when he holds those long notes, man, and you just kind of hear that voice just sing. Don't you love it when that happens? That's what I'm talking about. Okay. I like that. That's a, woo. That breakdown, man. Dang. Okay, I'm already starting to kind of get an idea of what we're talking about here. It's almost like he's the kind of like the overseer or the overruler, and he's pretty much commanding these people to build, you know, pretty much work as slaves, like build the like a shrine or like a tomb or whatever they're trying to, a palace, and he's saying, look how he fly, because he's pretty much governing over them. That's what I'm getting, kind of like a whole Moses and Ramses kind of story, right? Ruling over the people and building the stuff for them, that type of stuff, right? Okay. That one part where he rose his voice, where was it at? We're gonna go back a little bit right here. right there. That is so cold, because I swear to you, I thought he was going to end that on a lower note, right? But he said, right? And, oh, okay, okay, I see what he's doing out here. There's a shift in the music. Okay, there was a shift in the music when he started talking about when he sees his face. That was a very interesting shift, because it's almost as if that was like a climax. Right. You know, like when you're running away from a killer. Right. And then you finally turn that corner and you finally you feel like you realize you ran up to him, but you're in disbelief. So you start looking from the ground up and you're looking up during that. When they did that shift, which is probably like a modulation, when they went up and he started, when I see in his face, and it was like, duh, 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 that's almost like, hey, something's about to happen. I'm coming face to face for what's going on. I don't know. That was, it was just really weird for some reason. The imaging that I'm getting from this so far, from what I'm watching, is this guy, he's got a gray beard, he got a brown hat on, he's got this coat, and it's a purple coat with like gold inscriptions all around, and he's flying on a carpet like on Aladdin, and he's just flying around, and then you got these people with these bronze collars on, and they all have shirts on, but they don't got no pants on, and they're not on sand, they're on like cobblestone, and they got like these magical pickaxes that are conjured, because he made the weapons for them so they don't ever break. I got the most weirdest imagination, I swear. Sweat and tears. Oh, that's, oh, yes, yes. It's a very elongated guitar low, right? Right? Constellation, space. This little dude giving me a... That almost kind of had like a Hispanic nature to it. Woo. Oh, somebody stop this man. What an amazing composition. Kill. Like the coming to the realization of the actions that you've done. That's what this music right now is telling me. Building up to the climax. I'm like drawn into this. Okay, I'm always talking to you guys about like an artist's ability to retain retention to the listeners so that you ain't quick to like flip the switch, right? Now, one thing about the last like 2 minutes of that song is that the backtrack that and it kept playing it. I could listen to just that specific tune forever. It was such a good tune to just ride out. Dude can honestly just keep singing. Right. And I wouldn't even it's just one of those songs that I wouldn't care if it was just playing forever and ever and ever, especially just that last part. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's just a good arrangement of the music. Maybe it's just maybe it was just a good arrangement. I don't know. And then you got the singer in the background. He was going like 100 out of 10, like the entire song. Which can't be no easy feat. Got an amazing voice. Very high. Very lovely to listen to. And let's not even get about the story. We understood this. I understood the story. It looks like he once everything was finally built, they killed him. And what I'm guessing set themselves free. Was very interesting. Especially with the end. You know, he went up to a higher octave. And for the most part, he stayed in a higher octave. Right? Because assuming that I got the story right. They've gained their freedom. So we need to somehow reflect this in the music. And the best way you can do that is to sing your butt off, you know, and that's exactly what he did. Kind of drive that emotion. I mean, I could just imagine me just sitting in the car, just jamming, you know, the windows down. I'm just rolling. And then this is just going on in the background. You know, I'm pulling up to the streetlight, turning over, and all you hear is, I'm coming home. And I'm just looking over. I'm just like, yeah. This was an amazing tune, okay? I can tell you guys right now, okay, I am more of a, you know, even though I'm just now stumbling upon metal and rock and old school, I do like more of the modern things. Like, I don't mind, like a really old song, not really old, but like an old song like this that was in the 70s. I would like something a little bit more modern. But sometimes in order for me to understand a certain genre, I got to go back and look at the basics, right? as with any type of music genre, you can't just jump straight into it. So I'm all here for it. All right. All right, y'all. That's the end of this video. If you enjoyed the content, leave a like and subscribe. Dave's out.